We want to evaluate the definite integral of 2x to the third plus 3x to the fifth from negative 2 to 3. Before we do though, let's look at the graph of f of x equals 2x cubed plus 3x to the fifth over the closed interval from negative 2 to 3 graphed here below. Notice how because the function does drop below the x-axis over the interval from negative 2 to 0, the value of this definite integral will not give us the area bounded by the function on the x-axis. Because the value of the definite integral from negative 2 to 0 would be negative, because the area would be below the x-axis, and then on the interval from 0 to 3, because the area is above the x-axis, the value of the definite integral would be positive. We'll evaluate this using the fundamental theorem of calculus given here, where big F is the antiderivative of little f. So we'll begin by determining the antiderivative of 2x to the third plus 3x to the fifth. So for the antiderivative of 2x to the third, we'd have 2 times, we'll add 1 to the exponent and then divide by the new exponent, so that would be x to the fourth divided by 4, and then plus 3 times the antiderivative of x to the fifth. Again, we'll add 1 to the exponent and divide by the new exponent, giving us x to the sixth divided by 6. After simplifying this, we'll evaluate this at the upper limit of integration of 3, then the lower limit of integration of negative 2, and then find the difference. Notice here the 2 and the 4 simplify. The 2 simplifies to 1, the 4 simplifies to 2. So this would be 1 half x to the fourth. And here notice the 3 and the 6 simplify. There's 1 3 and 3 and 2 3s and 6. So we have plus 1 half x to the sixth. Because we have a common factor of 1 half though, let's go ahead and factor that out. So again, now we'll substitute 3 for x, then negative 2 for x, and then find the difference. And because we factored the 1 half out, we'll have to multiply this difference by 1 half once we simplify inside the brackets. So first we'll substitute 3 for x. That would give us 3 to the fourth plus 3 to the sixth minus, and now we'll substitute negative 2 for x. So we'll have negative 2 to the fourth plus negative 2 to the sixth. So we'll have 1 half times 3 to the fourth plus 3 to the sixth. Is equal to 810. And then negative 2 to the fourth plus negative 2 to the sixth would be 16 plus 64, or 80. So this is equal to 1 half times 810 minus 80 is equal to 730. And 1 half times 730 is equal to 365. I hope you found this helpful.